welcome to the show. You're watching Heads Up. E-commerce is the big buzzword in the country today, and the average Indian customer is being treated like royalty. But is the future of retail e-commerce, and is it fair to say that online will obliterate offline?
And that's the question we'll be answering today. The debate between online and offline rages on, and while both the sides have their own merits, today we will be discussing the concept of cross-channel retailing and hyper-local commerce, that is when brick meets click. And let's find out about the ground realities of this field from the retailers themselves.
When Nyasa launched their line of bath and body products, the initial target was retail stores. And that's a choice they succeeded in. Today, after 6 years, they own 7 stores and have tied up with over 20 shop-in-shop outlets. But restricting themselves to the offline space was not an option. And that's why, for the last 2 years, they have been reaching out to buyers online. Nyasa isn't the only brand to have picked up on the steadily growing demand for omnichannel retailing.
When we started Nyasa about 6 to 7 years back, it was the trend was the organized retail. About 2 years back, as you know that India is a young country, tech-savvy country. So a lot of youngsters are involved in internet. Internet availability is very easy nowadays. And with smartphones launched, everybody is just a click away. So everybody wants to shop online. Things are picking up. So we also keeping in tandem with the trend and the demand. We have our own portal, which is nyasabathandbody.com, wherein our customers can shop online.
But for starters, what exactly is cross-channel retailing? It's basically when brands and retailers use cross-channels to reach out to their customers, engage them and help them purchase. A few examples can be brick-to-click, where a consumer buys online but gets support in stores, devices-to-web, where customers can access web stores via kiosks, tablets and mobiles like the ShopSense technology. The cross-channel experience actually lets you research and shop from just about anywhere at your convenience.
If you see, the penetration of internet has greatly impacted the way consumer is shopping. Consumer is no longer homogeneous and shopping in one channel. The consumer is a hybrid in his behavior. He's shopping online, he's shopping offline through multiple devices. So omnichannel refers to a retailer's positioning of addressing this hybrid behavior of the consumer by offering a seamless experience across channels, across devices in an integrated manner. For example, your stores can become fulfillment centers, your stores can become experience centers, your online can become an experimentation or product launch tool. So there are multiple ways where you can integrate your different channels and offer a consumer a seamless experience.
From startups to well-known brands, they're all shelling out a large chunk of their money to capture the online market. US Polo, for instance, uses an active engagement platform at their stores wherein the customer can view all the products available at the store on this system. This cutting-edge technology by ShopSense is a classic example that sums up today's retail mantra, a blend between online and offline.
Well, as you know, the world is moving towards an omni-channel marketing and delivery of the consumer experience at the point of sale is becoming very, very important. So this is our first step that US Polo has taken in its flagship stores all over India, which is basically making the availability of the store in form of visuals, pictures and on-soms available to the consumer in the form of an app. So this app is installed in a technology which is called ShopSense, and where the consumer actually does not need to really go to the trial room to check out how he's looking, in which clothes, etc. He can try various on-soms here, he can check the prices, he can even check the availability here. And it's a great step in making shopping easy. First of all, people are very anxious to know what this is, because it's six times the size of a normal iPad or something like that, and they can actually interact with it. So it's got the resolution of a retina display. It has got a touch which is very, very smart and very fast. It's like a device even with kids can play. So it's not a kind of a barrier, but it's an enabler. And once people understand that, it's so easy to use and it is creating so much of convenience for them, it's almost like delivering an online experience offline in the store, they really feel very happy about it. So we have seen almost 50% of the people who are walking in now are using it.
Brands are spending a sizable amount to make their presence felt online. So Lakshmi, you spoke to a few companies who have taken their business multi-channel.
Yes, Ankita, quite a few. Experts are saying the reason why this cross-channel method is working is because no one person uses just one mode of communication today. In a world so connected, people are using multiple avenues to engage with brands and, of course, to purchase.
Here's one great example of cross-channel retailing. Electronics giant and offline player Croma today follows a store pickup approach to help customers shop easier. What this means is that you can make your purchase online at Croma.com, pay for it online, and just pick up the product at your convenience from a designated store or pickup point. Reports suggest that this platform is giving Croma about 1 crore rupees business every week. In addition to this, it helps Croma expand across the country, sans the costs.
One is, of course, there's increasing competition from online, which is impacting them, especially in select geographies. The impact is very high. So you are losing out to your consumer in the online world. The consumer who comes to your store is not shopping on your store in the online world. There's an opportunity loss and there is increasing competition. So there is a compulsion to be present online. It's more than an opportunity, it's become a necessity. The second reason is that there's structural issues with brick and mortar retail. So if you see, even after being present in India for more than 2 decades, organized brick and mortar is concentrated in the top few cities. So almost 56% of organized retail is in top 24 cities. But the demand for brands, for products is throughout India. And e-tailing bridges this gap very well. And that's why we find that so many of the e-tailers actually getting more than 50% of their sales from beyond the tier one towns.
And it's not just the offline brick and mortar players who are doing the cross-channel dance. While startups innovate with new products for this, even online-first companies are increasingly taking their stores and brands offline, like online jewelry major Bluestone.com. Bluestone has opened physical guide stores in various cities where they display prototypes of their products. This is to help customers get a touch and feel of the product before they buy it. Apart from this, they also allow customers to try on products at their homes before buying it.
Online is great for browsing. Online is great for discovery. Online is great to spend 1 month on a purchase that you are thinking of buying. Okay, and offline is still good at providing that last minute comfort in the overall sales process. A classic example is categories like cars and houses. I mean, we all do a lot of research online, but we obviously can't buy a house online. We can't buy a car online. So it just depends on the involvement required in those categories. So that decides whether you need an offline component to cater to that comfort also that people are generally used to. See, customer response has been great. What happens is there are a few customers who are evolved in their overall comfort with online. So for many of those customers, they are fine. They are fine with just spending months, 2 months online, looking for the product, looking for the design that they want, and then ordering it. Also, in cases where you don't like the eventual product that you see, because again, it's an intangible product, it's not like a box product. So in cases where you don't, for any reason, if the product does not match your expectation, you can return it within a month and we give you back your full money. But historically, because we are wired like that, there are still a lot of people who are just not comfortable making that expensive decision purely online without speaking to a human, without that human interface. So for those people, I think our offline touch points that we have established, those are serving a great purpose.
And it isn't restricted to Croma and Bluestone. Offline and online players jumping on the cross-channel bandwagon include, of the traditional players, the Future Group, who have planned a 100 crore rupee investment in cross-channel retailing across its brands. Offline textile major Arvind Mills hopes to enter the e-commerce space with its Create brand. Raymond Suitings has its online store Raymond Next, and even Titan has opened its online stores for its watch and jewelry brands. Apart from this, online first stores like Fab Furnish and First Try have several offline stores across several cities in the country. Lingerie player Zivame has also started trial fitting rooms for its customers, while Myntra and Zovi are planning offline stores for the same reason.
Between now and 2020, modern retail will add another $100 billion traditional retail will add, I think, almost $380 billion. So it's not that they will stop growing. It's just that e-tailing will grow at a much faster pace, and in some of the geographies like larger towns, the impact will be much more than in other places. So all the channels will continue to coexist, but each of the channels, especially the organized brick and mortar space, will need to find out ways of integrating the digital into their strategies, because it's something you can't wish away now. We think that by 2020, almost 10% of e-tailing should come from multi-channel players.
So cross-channel retail, clearly the next leg of the retailing journey in India. Up next, your favorite Kirana store goes digital.
So we spoke about top retail brands who are carving their niche in the online space. But what about your very own and favorite Kirana stores or the shop round the corner? Ever felt lazy to step out of your home and shop for groceries?
And wished you could just order online or from an app? Well, now you can, all thanks to certain innovative startups and the concept of hyper-local commerce. Here's a look.
Sunil Babu's Kirana store in Bangalore has been around for over 8 years now. He runs the business single-handedly and clocks in over 20 customers a day on good days. However, with the entry of bigger online players like Big Basket, his grocery business was taking a hit.
Gaadi chah rahe hain, Jip Store wala aake uska progress sham karke, wo ek din aagaya, aake pataya Jip Store aisa ek app lagaya, aapko link usme link hone hai to link karke order milega karke bola. फिर हमारा तो बिग बास्केट आने के बाद वो थोड़ा कस्टमर उसमें गया था, फिर यहाँ जिप स्टोर लगाया, फिर उसमें से थोड़ा कस्टमर वापस आया, लेकिन थोड़ा ज़्यादा नहीं हुआ, थोड़ा दिन ही हुआ के 3 महीने हुआ, अच्छा चल रहा है, ऑर्डर भी अच्छा आ रहा है उसमें, पहले से भी थोड़ा ऑर्डर इंक्रीज हो गया।
सुनील सून रियलाइज दैट यू कुड ओनली फाइट फायर विद फायर, एंड टू हेल्प हिज बिजनेस थ्राइव ही टू नीडेड टू गेट डिजिटल. And that's when he stumbled upon an app, Jip Store, a mobile commerce platform that helps connect Kirana stores and local supermarkets with customers and vice versa.
Customer to acha response de rahe customer sab, wo thoda log gaya tha na Big Basket ne, log sab wapas aaya, wo log ko tha bol raha tha Big Basket ne, usko bhi Big Basket ne jane ka easy tha, isliye hamare paas option nahi tha na, isliye hum Jip Store lagaya, to wo log wapas aaye bola acha ho gaya. हमको भी इसी है, क्योंकि पुराना कस्टमर था हमारा, सब वो पुराना कस्टमर है, और लोग भी वापस आए, इसमें अच्छा ऑर्डर भी मिल रहा है।
The Jip Store app allows customers within a locality find grocery stores within their given area. It helps them place the orders through the app and get them delivered to their doorstep. As for the shop owners, it gives them data like the most ordered products from the store, most items commonly bought together, buying patterns and other customer data. This helps the shopkeepers stock inventory accordingly and reduces waste.
There were problems such as parking space issue, rush at the store, and the identification of the store itself was a big difficulty. Now, Jip Store, what it provides to an end user is that store discovery. Now you can order through all this online media, and that brings in more sales to the store. And the data which the store guy gets, which helps him in better engaging with the users through this mobile and web platform, is bringing back sales to him. So that's the real benefit for the shop guy. See, phone ordering has a lot of difficulty. One thing is the local language issue, which every one of us face in a city like Bangalore or Mumbai or Chennai. We all go to bigger supermarkets because we can't communicate to the normal store guy, which is down the road. Now that Jip Store solves that problem. You don't have to physically communicate to him. We take care of that part. And more importantly, there is clarity on product selection. You order through your mobile, just typing in what you want or selecting the items. The store guy exactly knows what you ordered for. And this is a benefit which actually helps him make a better decision than phone ordering.
Okay. Jip Store was started in 2013 by 4 friends whose expertise was in the mobile and analytics field. In just over a year, over 83 small and medium-sized stores in Bangalore City have already adopted their mobile commerce platform to leverage business. With the subscription model with prices as low as 1,500 rupees, it isn't a wonder that the app is fast catching on.
Initially, when we started off, the domain which you are trying to make organized or make a little bit more smart is highly unorganized. So they don't have processes, they have less staff, they have less infrastructure. So for us, one challenge was finding out a solution which is so simple to use, which can be easily adopted by anyone with very less skills, very less capital to invest on. So that was the initial challenge which we had. So right now there are around 7.4 million stores in India. That's a very huge penetration. In Bangalore alone, 15,000 stores are there. So when we look at a market value as such, for our business, it stands at around $1.4 billion per year.
Now that's an example of hyperlocal commerce. While the e-commerce wars in India have already kicked off, their counterparts abroad are still testing the waters for concepts like cross-channel retailing and hyperlocal commerce.
Few Indian companies have also taken a leaf out of the books of their counterparts abroad when it comes to hyperlocal commerce. For example, Croma's purchase online, pick up offline approach was inspired from electronics counterpart, the Best Buy store in the USA. Amazon Fresh, Walmart's TuGo, eBay Now and Google's Shopping Express are all examples of hyperlocal commerce. All of them provide platforms that leverage local stores to deliver goods to buyers.
In a hyperlocal commerce state, the vendors and the consumers will be very close to each other. So as a result, if I'm ordering something today, a vendor very close, very in my vicinity will be fulfilling that order. So it will reduce supply chain complexities, it will reduce time and as well as costs incurred, and as well as my product will come much faster because it's being fulfilled by a local vendor. So effectively, I'm buying from the localized local market itself. It's like earlier I used to go out and buy, now I'm buying online. But if you see from an Indian perspective, this is a very long-term, I would say a long-term goal. You know, ultimately all marketplaces would like to have vendors across multiple cities and zones. But, you know, the vendor base in India is not a very evolved vendor base. They still lack digital literacy. You have to really invest in training them to cater to the e-tailing market. So this will require thousands and thousands of vendors across geographies, across India, across product categories, so that every city or every cluster gets addressed through a local network of vendors. So it's a very long-term, I think, scenario for India. But of course, that's a state which every marketplace would like to reach, because a lot of efficiencies can be realized, and you know, it's a less complex scenario, and it will also save on the cost of fulfillment.
Catering to this very demand, stores like Local Banya have come up, making lives easier for the urban homemaker, as now you can sit at home and order in even your groceries and other perishable items. This is one facility buyers like Anita Gonsalves swear by.
First of all, I can do it at my dining table with the computer. I don't have to, you know, be working. I don't have to sort of take a day to, oh, now I need to buy groceries. Now I need to buy vegetables, or I need to buy toiletries. It's all under one roof. Plus the health foods that are available, and the imported goods, which you don't really get. So I have to go and search. So this is extremely convenient, and I can do it at any time. You know, after work, 12 o'clock at night, all I do is, you know, go to the website and order whatever I need and state the time to be delivered, and it's there.
Grocery e-tailing is a comparatively new field that has seen a large number of startups making their foray. But unlike other forms of e-commerce, e-tailing groceries has many challenges. Logistics and operations are key factors that draw in customers here. Retailers believe that hyperlocal commerce in the groceries sector is definitely catching up and is the answer to the logistical challenges that the e-tailing grocery businesses face.
One of the beauties of being online is that you get to, your order is first and then the delivery is later, vis-a-vis a brick and mortar wherein a customer enters, picks everything that he wants. So at the point of shopping at a brick and mortar, a customer needs to be present. The good thing for us is the order comes in prior, so we know what a customer is demanding and what he wants for it. This helps us plan better for them and give them fresher produce, especially in case of fresh fruits and vegetables. We get them on a daily basis fresh, exactly the amount that the customer requires. So there is no wastage from our end as well.
With all that's going on in this space, there is one clear winner, and that is the customer.
Absolutely, Ankita. Consumers reaping in the benefits of the changes in the retail landscape. That's all we have for you on the show today. Thanks for watching.